right, thanks for everyone being here in the Murray Room at the CFSB Center for a little time with Q&A with head coach Steve Prohm. Also, our athletics director, Kevin Saal, is here as well as we stream live on ESPN Plus and Facebook as well. All our TV stations are good. All right, Steve, let's just start with you and maybe just your first thoughts of the public celebration this morning and then going into it here.
Thanks, Dave. Appreciate you. And obviously thanks to Kevin and Bob and everybody that, you know, gave me the opportunity to come back here. Obviously the one thing that the reason I came back, I think it's a different job from where I left when I left. And the biggest thing about it is this logo you see, the Valley. It's a great logo. It's a great league. Obviously spent a lot of time in the Midwest. I've got a great deal of respect and admiration for the league. It's one of the top 10 leagues in the country. You know, it's a league that can send multiple teams to the NCAA tournament. And it's a league that, you know, has a lot of respect nationwide as one of the best basketball leagues in the country. And it's a great challenge, a great opportunity. And though this program has had great tradition in the Ohio Valley Conference, I'm back because it's a brand new chapter for me and this university and chasing our first Valley championship. And so excited to get started.
Thanks, Steve. We're going to open up for questions now. If you would, I'll make my just signal to me and I'll get to you. And just give us your name and what outlet you're from and then go ahead and ask your question. Neil Bradley from Racer Radio is going to get the first question.
All right. Welcome back, Steve. Glad that you're here. Sorry I couldn't make the public event. I couldn't find my car keys this morning.
I know. Only so many people know that story.
But you'll see that everyone else does. Have you contacted the 22-23 Racer recruits, and also how active will you be in the transfer portal, if at all?
Yeah, we'll be active in the portal for sure. With the recruits, yes. First day I got the job, I talked to everybody on the current roster, talked to all the recruits, all their families, high school coaches, AAU coaches. So everything's never perfect in a transition, but I feel really, really good about where we're at with a lot of those with the signees, and so excited to get out here once I get what I need done here the next day or two here on campus. Excited to go see those guys.
Adam Wells, WPSD. Coach, how quickly did it become apparent that you wanted to return here to Murray once Matt left for LSU?
You know, when I first moved back here, you know, it was obviously they were still in the OVC, and then, you know, a couple people reached out. I actually did a little video, you know, in anticipation of trying to get into the Valley. And so I think when they joined the Valley, obviously it becomes on your radar. My wife's from here. My family's from here. We were back in this area, but try not to be, you know, here all the time. Obviously, we live about 45 minutes from here. But, you know, I've been a head coach here. I've been a head coach at Iowa State. I just know after sitting out, and I wanted to make sure I made the right decision, not only for me, my family, of a place that I can win basketball games, I can be connected in the community, I can be Steve Prohm, and, you know, I can make my family happy. And so I was actually in a parent-teacher conference for Francie, came out, you know, Matt had taken the job, and really my first thought, I'm really happy for him. I mean, obviously we got a great relationship, and to see his success is phenomenal. And so, and then I just reached out to some people and said if they would have some interest, I'd love to talk to Kevin, and it kind of went from there, and honestly went a lot quicker than probably our first conversation I thought it would go. But that's really a good thing, so we can get up and running.
We'll go right over here. Coach Prohm, Todd Richards with KFES. And talk about the level of expectations as you make that move from the Ohio Valley Conference to the Missouri Valley Conference.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's the great thing about Murray State. It's what you sign up for. You know, whether it's your first job or your third job, you're under the microscope at this job. You know, you got unbelievable fan support. You got unbelievable expectations. Jokingly, you know, they'll probably give me 1 year to just finish in the top half, and then they expect you to win the league. But the standard's the standard here, and that's why I'm here. I've been part of championships in the OVC. I've been a part of championship teams in the Big 12. And so I understand, like I said, I respect this league immensely. It's got great coaches, tremendous players. It's a league, like I said, can win tournament games, get multiple teams in the league. But the standard's the standard here, and that's the playing postseason play and win championships.
We'll go right here in the back.
Jake Siegel, coach, nice to meet you. I'm with WSIL. How do you plan to make your second stint here more successful than your first stint?
Yeah, I think that's one of the things you talk about, and Kevin and I talked about that. I didn't come back to live in the past. I didn't come back to relive a ninth, being the ranked ninth team in the country or a 25-game winning streak. You know, I came back to go win Met Valley championships. And so this is a new chapter for me, for the school, the university. That's in the past. The OVC, it's closed. It's an amazing run. This last decade, you talk about Ja Morant, Cameron Payne, Isaiah Cannon. I think Shaq Buchanan's played in the NBA. Tevin and KJ have opportunities. Jonathan Stark's been in the G League. You talk about tournament wins. You talk about ranked teams. We've had three ranked teams in the last, several years here. Like I said, Matt put an exclamation point on the OVC the way he finished it, and that's behind us all. And so I'm not comparing, and I don't want anybody to compare that. The comparison is the thief of joy, and I'm here for a whole new beginning.
Steve, Jeff Bidwell, WPSD. 11 years ago, you stood up here for your first head coaching job, terrified standing behind the microphone.
Yep.
In those 11 years to today, how have you changed as a person and how have you changed as a coach, do you think?
Well, I was telling, I forget who I was talking to out there. Obviously, a lot, I've got so much familiarity here. And that was really when I came here for the first time. I hadn't been back since I got the job till last night. And I told Katie driving home, I said, man, it just feels right, man. I feel really good. I'm in a good place. I just kind of feel like I'm back to myself. I think your documentary, honestly, it helped. It kind of hit some points I needed to. It was the right time, to watch that. And I appreciate your efforts with that, from that standpoint. But, I'm excited. This is a phenomenal place. Great people, great expectations. I'm just ready to get started, from that standpoint. I started getting sidewind. Repeat your question because I had to, I got a little sidetracked.
How have you changed as a coach?
I think number one, obviously I jokingly say, man, I took the job. I was nervous. I understood the expectations, but I was single, when I say single, I wasn't married. Now I show up here, four kids, a wife. We're going to be almost married 9 years this summer. And so, obviously, I think I have a great balance in my life. But I understand, especially because I've seen the high and low of this. You know what I mean? I've won championships, played deep in the postseason. And I've also been, I've also parted ways with programs, or you fired. I mean, I've got humility. You got to have humbleness through success. And then you got to have humbleness and humility through failure as well. And I wouldn't call it failure. I just... but you got to be able to grow in both areas. And so I think the year off was great for me. I put myself in a great mindset. I think physically I'm in a great place. Mentally I'm in a great place. But I think the one thing I do think, I love basketball. I love watching tape. I love watching film, X's and O's, figuring out the next play. But I think the more you're in it and the more you sit out and, like you say, you grow – and I think your documentary hit this on this. It's really just about those 13 guys. We could run whatever we want to run. If you've got investment and you got commitment, we'll figure that piece out. And I think that's the biggest thing, is just getting back to how can I be significant in those guys' lives.
We'll stay right here in the front.
Okay. Steve, Todd Hamilton, WHOP. What do you see different about this program now from when you were here before, in addition to going to the Missouri Valley?
Yeah, I think the Valley's the biggest thing, but like I touched on in the press conference, I told Kevin, like, the standard hasn't changed here. Matt just won 31 games, went 31-3, and, was in a couple minutes away from going to the Sweet 16 again. And so, I mean, like I jokingly said, Matt Bees, that's where I'm going to go eat pizza, and that's just not much has changed. Now, I will say, I told Kevin, I've been very impressed with, the level of excellence from his staff, the communication. They've been on it, like it should be, like we're a high major program because we have high major expectations. And so, I don't know if anything's changed, but those are some things that have stuck out to me. And I told Kevin that his staff's been really, really good. Brock, been on top of everything and ahead of the game, and I think that's been really, really impressive to see. And so I don't know if what's really changed, honestly. I mean, we got a beautiful gym. I've been around. I told Kevin this. Our practice facility is as good as there is. Obviously, there's things you can always do to, you know, keep things new and relevant, but we got a phenomenal practice facility. We got a great fan base, great support. Not much.
Steve, we'll stay right here in the front.
Will Aubrey, MERSports.net. Coach, with the exception of KJ Williams and Tevin Brown, who are expected to move on to the pros, do you expect most of the guys who played a significant role on this year's team to stay?
I mean, if I'm just shooting you straight, I met with Juice yesterday. I'm going to meet with Trey tomorrow. Obviously, Tevin and KJ, you know, are moving on to great, you know, opportunities for them from that standpoint. I'm going to visit with them, and then they need to do what's best for them. I mean, there's no decision 100% made. You know, maybe tough for them to return, maybe not. I'm going to sit down, visit with them, but I told them I'm going to do whatever I can to help them. But that's just part of this world we're in right now in college athletics, to where, you know, if they do move on, I wish them the best. If they stay, obviously, I think we have as good of a backcourt that we'll have in the Missouri Valley Conference, and excited to get to work with those guys. But you got to live in the moment, and I think that's another thing I learned is just take it a day at a time. You know, can't think a week ahead, 2 weeks ahead. You know, what do we got to attack today? And we're going to attack it, and then we'll go to the next thing. You know, the thing I told Juice is, you know, hey, you know, my last four point guards, they all played in the NBA. They've all been drafted. You know, that I think he'd have a seamless transition if he stayed here.
We'll stay right here in front.
Kevin, Tony Kendall, Paris Post Intelligencer. When you learned that Matt was leaving, how did your process start?
That's a good question. I appreciate that. It starts very quickly. Certainly have thoughts in your mind in order to be proactive and be prepared. But I think the few factors that play into it in terms of our guys being on spring break and back home, certainly there's always a sense of urgency, and there's other factors that play into that. So immediately when we get word, obviously have conversations with Coach Mack and wish him well, and that relationship will continue. But we needed very quickly to pivot and determine what was best for Murray State. And so we spent the next 48 hours constantly on the phone and Zoom, and walked through what Murray State fans would think would be a very gratifying process. And I will tell you that throughout the course of that process, as much interest, coveted interest in this job, there is not a candidate that would measure up to Coach Prohm and what he brings. And for me, it's obviously the competitive aspects are incredibly important, but from a character and integrity standpoint, from a relationship standpoint, those were the clear separators for me. So I'm just as thrilled as I could be to lock arms with Coach Prohm and build this program as we head into the Missouri Valley Conference.
We'll stay right here with Jared.
Jared Jensen, Paducah Sun. This question could be for either of you or both of you. With a job coming back, is this a new job mentality, or is this a coming back job mentality?
Yeah. I think I touched on that earlier. I think it's a new job mentality. I mean, it's great to be back. I mean, I had two children born here. My wife's from here. We got phenomenal relationships. We got family. I mean, this is our home. You know, I've moved. You know, I've lived in Virginia and Georgia and North Carolina. But if you ask me anywhere, when I was in Iowa, home is here. This is home. And so, obviously, it's great to be home. It's great to coach at a university that I got great admiration and love for. But this is a new job, and it's a new opportunity. You know, probably if it's in OVC, it's a different job. But I want this challenge, you know. I mean, it's a new challenge. It's a great challenge, and it's a challenge that I want to take. But I would take it. It's definitely a new job mentality without question.
All right, any others? Jeremy? go ahead.
How much joy did you get in this season off of being able to be an assistant coach with your son in upper league basketball?
You know, I'll miss that, you know, and it's funny, the guy I coached with, he texts me, he goes, can I get on your staff? And I said, I doubt it. But it was great, man. I mean, that's the one thing, and I'm 47, but but my kids are young. I mean, 7, 4, 2, and a newborn, and be 5 and 3 next week, April 4th and 6th. But, man, I went to cheerleading practice. You know, I went to basketball practice. I coached basketball teams, and, you know, and the one, and then Upward Bound, the one guy looked at my wife, he goes, this is the best assistant coach I've ever had in this league. And so, but I took pride, you take pride in that, you know, so, but it was, man. And my son, man, you were sitting in, I'll tell this one story. We were we went to Nashville for the weekend when we were playing in Indianapolis. I just got the family out of town. We just go down there to relax and take the kids a couple places. And we were watching the game, and three of my kids are asleep, Cass is up, but Katie and I, we're watching it with high five, and not high, but I'm pumping fists, and Cass is into it, and Cass starts crying after we got beat, and I was like, man, maybe that is where I need to be, if that opportunity, because this is kind of what we know, and this is who we are and what we're about. And obviously I had great times at Iowa State, and very fortunate to be there and coach great players and had great moments, but I'm excited about the future here.
We'll go one more here in the front.
John Wright, Murray Ledger and Times. You were here once before. You know the atmosphere here in Murray. How much of an advantage is that for you? You know what the fans expect. How much of an advantage is that for you coming back here?
Well, it's an advantage because at least I know them well. So they'll give me a little bit of leeway, you know. But, yeah, I think it's an advantage because I've got, you know, really good relationships and investment in this community and with a lot of people here. But the expectations, you know, I mean, if we don't win, they're going to be mad at me. I mean, I get it, you know. So, the standard is excellence here. I mean, look at the banners, you know, everybody says, you know, hey, you know, Murray State, they just, you know, you just go there, you win. Well, I mean, look at the last decade. You just don't go win 31 games three different times by three, you know, like that's elite. You don't go just win NCAA tournament games and be on the brink of Sweet 16. You just don't have lottery picks. Your three-point guard, last point guard, just don't go play in the NBA. Like, that's high major stuff there. And that's the mentality of the program. That's the mentality, in the time that I've dealt with Kevin. And that's the mentality of our fans. I mean, this is, you know, they have high major expectations. And I'm excited. I'm excited, man. The Valley is phenomenal basketball league. And, you know, from Ben and Darren there's some phenomenal coaches. Obviously, those are Iowa guys, so I know them well and done a lot of functions with them. But I'm excited.
And Neil Bradley, Racer Radio Network. Coach, you mentioned Marcus Brown being a part of your staff. Tell me about the important parts of putting a staff together and what you'll look for in putting the rest of your staff together.
I think the one thing, I think number one, alignment and chemistry. You know, I think it starts with that. I want great alignment, great chemistry, and great connection. Whether they've recruited or haven't recruited, if they can bring that to the table, then everything else will figure itself out. So I think that's number one. Obviously, Marcus will be back. I'd like to hire one person that has some familiarity with me from that standpoint. Just so they understand my terminology and they can help, you know, in the transition from that standpoint, or somebody I can call right away and say, hey, this is what I'm looking for. And then I'll hire two more people that obviously can, you know, obviously, you know, I've been a head coach for a while, so I want to give them, these assistants, a lot of autonomy, whether it's on the offensive side of the ball, defensive side of the ball, what I would call special teams, underneath, out of bounds, side out of bounds, press attack. So I want guys that can do that. And are well-rounded, from being great coaches, being guys that can bring great student athletes here, but also be connectors in the community, because I understand what that means as well. So I think, you know, coachable, challenge, and then connectivity. I think that's the biggest key, those three C's that I heard earlier this year.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Kevin. We are going to have some breakout time here as well. And thank you for everyone watching on ESPN Plus and Facebook, and we will end our event at this time. Thank you.